Me and My Katamari for the PlayStation Portable may satisfy the fans of this quirky, ball-oring franchise, since the same enjoyable gameplay has been made portable. But since the PSP has many limitations that the bigger home consoles don't, not everything is quite right with this iteration. Now, I felt these hindrances without even having had played the previous PS2 Katamari games, because one of the most annoying issues has to do with the fact that the PSP only has one analog nub. Because of this, controls for the game takes getting used to. The face buttons of the PSP tries to compensate for the missing second analog stick, but does so in a very awkward way. For one, to move forward, the triangle button must be held while pushing the PSP's analog nub forward. Also, camera control is too slow and not very responsive, and thus, what should be a straightforward game with very simple concept of rolling ball around becomes fairly difficult and frustrating in certain instances. Even after getting used to controls, it's not that rare to get stuck between buildings and other situations which can take some frustrating button mashing to get out of. The game is really simple most of the time though. All sorts of animals want islands for themselves, different kinds of islands, soft islands, hard islands, smart islands, whatever. And to make these islands, the tiny prince, or his many cousins, must roll a ball called the Katamari, as it rolls up the object it touches and thereby growing bigger and bigger with each object it rolls up. That is really the gist of the game, to roll a ball around to make it bigger. What makes the game fun are seeing the Katamari grow bigger and bigger so they can swallow up all kinds of different objects, from candy bars to panda bears and even up to islands and entire continents. There are so many objects to roll up, even innocent school children screaming for their lives. It feels really wrong, but at the same time, immensely satisfying. However, as you'd expect from such a simple game concept, the game gets repetitive and old pretty fast. The concept itself is not at fault here, since the game's design makes this dreaded feeling rather inevitable. Many of the stages are recycled over and over again, just far too many times. By the end of the game, players will have come across the zoo at least 5 times, the city at least 10 times, and the park at least 15 times. I'm probably not accurate with those numbers, but it sure felt like I played those stages that many times. This isn't to say that the level variety doesn't happen, since some side missions do spite things a bit, by changing the objectives to so that the Katamaris can only collect candies or energy-related things or the like. But even so, only the most hardcore Katamari fans wouldn't find this game repetitive. Even if those fans get over the repetition, I highly doubt they would find many reasons to replay the game. Unknockable presents and more playable characters, the prince has a lot of cousins, can be rolled up during the game, but they do not at all enhance the game in any way other than just aesthetics. It's funny to wear wings and put on the mask of the king of all cosmos, but without these rewards doing anything, and they don't do anything, it just feels empty. All levels can be tried again to beat a previous score, but again, I don't know why someone would do so. Me and My Katamari is still a really fun game at times, though its humor is just too strange to understand. But as a PSP title, it's just very unfortunate that it brings the franchise back. Not only because of the awkward control setup, but due to its lack of level variety, and also because of the long loading times that most PSP games are infamous of having. There's still a lot to be impressed here, especially for Katamari fans who'll find the exact same gameplay and graphics, but just made portable. But the sacrifice made to make this game portable may have been just a bit too much.